Hello, good morning, dear students. Last time you have started the chapter electrochemistry, but unfortunately the connections were not proper and the class was not conducted in this smooth manner. Today, once again, I am here with the chapter electrochemistry, and today we will try to give a fresh start, as every new morning comes with the new hopes. And the same way, with the new hope, with the new zeal, with the new spirit, we will start the chapter electrochemistry. Just in a very quick way, I am going to recapitulate the things we have discussed in the first class, and then we will continue with the coming part of the chapter. The electrochemistry, this is the chapter that studies the interconversion of chemical energy and electrical energy. The electrochemistry, the electricity and chemistry, they are related together. The electron involved in the chemical reactions, right, has the ability to produce the electric current, and similarly by the flow of the electric current, non-spontaneous reactions can be carried out, and this is studied in the electrochemistry. The basically nature of the reaction, the type of the reaction that is studied in the electrochemistry is the redox reaction. Redox reaction is the reaction in which simultaneously one species undergo the oxidation process and the other species undergo the reduction process. The oxidation, the process of losing of the electron, right? The positive change in the oxidation state or the oxidation number. This is called the oxidation, we have discussed in the previous class. And reduction is the process of gain of electron. The gain in the electron is called the reduction. And definitely there is a negative change in the oxidation state. There is a decrease in the oxidation state of any of the species during the reduction reaction. This is the key point. Whenever you want to identify which species is undergoing the oxidation, okay, and which species is undergoing the reduction reaction, always account for the change in the oxidation state. The charge present on any of the species is defined as the oxidation state or the oxidation number. The atoms, the neutral atoms of any element, always the oxidation state is zero. The overall oxidation state of any of the molecule is always zero, and this zero is the arithmetic sum of the participating or the constituting atoms present in the molecule. For example, the sulfuric acid H2SO4, the overall oxidation state of this is zero, right? But this is the sum of the oxidation states of hydrogen, one sulfur, and the four oxygen, which are constituting to the sulfuric acid, right? So always these are the basic concepts that we account during the calculation of the oxidation number. So whenever we have to go for the oxidation and reduction reaction, always the increase, a positive change in the oxidation state is oxidation, a negative change in the oxidation state is reduction. Now we will not go for the definition based on the addition and removal of the hydrogen, right? This is the concept that we will apply in the class 12, right? Now I am coming to the word electrochemical cell, right? Where all these changes, change of electrical energy into the chemical energy and the chemical energy to the electrical energy, takes place that device is called the electrochemical cell, and two types of the cells are there. We have discussed, right? The first type of the cell is the galvanic cell. That today we are going to study in detail. And the second type of the cell is electrolytic cell. Cell means the device, right? The meaning of cell is not the biological unit, the constituting of bodybuilding unit. No, it's not here. Here is, it is a device where the redox reaction takes place, right? This can take place in one pot or more than one pot are required, right? As the two reactions are proceeding together, oxidation and reduction, right? So electrochemical cell, right? Electrochemical cell, it is the device, right? The device in which the chemical energy is converted into the electrical energy, and in this always a spontaneous chemical reaction, a spontaneous redox reaction takes place. The vice versa situation, right? You have taken the electrolyte, you have added the inserted, you have dipped the metallic rock, but reaction was not taking place at all. You have allowed the electric current to flow through it, right? And then what you see that now the chemical reaction takes place. This is the electrolytic cell. Whenever by the flow of electric current, right, the electrical energy is converted into the chemical energy. A chemical reaction, a non-spontaneous redox reaction takes place by the virtue by the flow of the electric current. This device is called electrolytic cell, where this takes place, and the phenomena, the reaction is called electrolytic cell. So two types of the cells are the galvanic cell, also known as the voltaic cell, and the Daniell cell, of course. Right? Whenever condition is standard, that can be used the term. All the three terms are used on the name of the scientist. Today in our class, we are going to study the galvanic cell in the detail. First of all, its definition. What changes take place here? It is a device in which by a spontaneous, this word is very important, spontaneous and non-spontaneous. It makes a difference between the galvanic cell and the electrolytic cell, right? A spontaneous chemical reaction takes place, and which spontaneous reaction takes place? Redox reaction takes place. The spontaneous redox reaction takes place, and by this spontaneous redox reaction, what happens? The electricity is generated, and this electricity is used to get work done, right? So many, all the electrical devices, the cells, the batteries that you are using, this is in your simple watch, you use this battery, right? By this batteries, cells, glass, or so many other examples are there, and it is the source of electric current for the different machineries, for the different equipments that is used here, right? So this is the device where this takes place. The chemical energy is transformed into the electrical energy, and this entire chapter is about this transformation of energy from one form to another. Here, redox reaction takes place, means definitely both the reactions are taking place, oxidation as well as the reduction. Simultaneously, two processes take place together, since I said it is a redox reaction. And container, one vessel. In this one broad district, and this broad district, the very common example I am taking first, because always from common to uncommon it goes. It works. The kids and you already know it's easy to grasp. Zinc rod is chipped into the zinc sulfate. This is one part. What is actually happening here? The zinc is losing its electron and getting converted into the zinc plus ions. This is the actual phenomena that is going to take place. What this reaction is? This is the oxidation process, the losing of electron. The zinc has converted itself into the zinc plus ions. Two electrons are released. The process of electronation is called oxidation. This container, this form, where this oxidation is taking place, this is not a complete reaction. It is half reaction. Two reactions are together. That is the total overall cell reaction. Half of its part is oxidation and half of its part is the reduction. So this part, right, where the one particular reaction takes place, either the oxidation or the reduction, this is called half cell. What we call to it, it is called as, is known as the half cell. And the reaction that takes place in this part of the cell is called half cell reaction. What is called? It is called half cell reaction. And since this reaction is oxidation, we can define it as the oxidation half cell or oxidation half reaction. That means a galvanic cell, a Daniell cell or a Voltaic cell is consist of two reactions and two half cells. First half cell where the oxidation takes place, always by the default, as per the rule, as the convention decided by the international organization, is always written in the left hand side. The right hand side you can see another one. What has actually taken place here? The zinc is tipped in the zinc sulfate solution. What happens? Zinc gets converted into the zinc plus ion. This is always decided by the couple that participate in the reaction, that which one will go undergo oxidation and which will undergo the reduction reaction. And it is always decided by the electrochemical series, its reactivity or the standard electrode potential that we will discuss as the session will progress. Now you can see here the second part of the cell. In this second part of the cell, the copper, mostly brown in color, that's why the symbolic color I have used, copper sulfate, a very well-known solution. You all can identify by its color, and this color is always the fine neck of copper color, right? A very beautiful color, copper sulfate, blue in color. What happens actually here, due to the difference in their standard electrode, the copper 2 plus ion from the solution. The copper sulfate is dissociated, gives the Cu plus and SO4 2 minus ions, and this copper sulfate from the solution, it moves towards the rod. And what it does? It receives the electron, it takes the electron from this rod and gets converted into the copper. And being neutral, solution of the electrolytic compound, right, is called electrolyte, right? The substance that on dissolving water gets ionized is called the electrolyte. The ionic compounds on dissolving in the water has the ability to ionize, right? And this solution that is taken in any part of the cell is always called the electrolyte. The metallic rod, right? This metallic rod that is dipped in this solution is called the electrode. What we call it? Electrode. And there are two types of the electrodes. One is cathode and another is anode. Two types of electrodes are there. One is always in the anode and the other is cathode. My dear students, one thing I just want to make it very clear here. Generally, how you all learn that cathode positive, anode negative, vice versa. This is the way by the chart you define the anode and cathode. My dear students, this is the wrong way. And in this case, you will be always confused. Whenever you will go for the electrolytic cell and electrochemical cell, galvanic cell, in both the conditions, the signs, the symbols are going to change and you will get confused. Always and always remember the anode and cathode by the reaction that takes place in their position. Just now we will discuss it. Just let me finish this one. Here, copper is the electrode that is dipped in the copper sulfate solution. Right? What happens at this phase? What is going to take place here? The copper ion is converted into the copper. What is actually taking place here? The copper is gaining the electron. It is the receiving of the electron. From the solution it is taking the electron. And this is, my dear student, reduction reaction. Always we define the process of gain of electron as the reduction reaction, right? Oxidation is always the donation of the electron, process of releasing of the electron. Just vice versa, the gain of electron is called the reduction reaction, right? Again, this is half part of the cell, half of the reaction is taking place here. Which reaction is taking place here? The reduction. So, this part of the cell will be called as the reduction half cell. What will be the name of this? Since it is not the complete cell, it represents to the half part of the cell, we call it half cell. And since the reaction that takes place here is the reduction reaction, the name for this cell is the reduction half cell. And the reaction is called reduction half reaction. What we call this? The reduction half reaction. That means cell is consist of two half cells. And you can see in the diagram that both the half cells are separate. At this part, the electrons are generated, and at this part, the electrons are consumed. They are received, they are taken, right? But do you think, is it possible without any connection that these electrons can move from one place to another? Since they are not interconnected, they are in the different containers. Here is the use of one bridge. What is the bridge in the rivers? And if some of you have visited the Mumbai, the most beautiful bridge of the Mumbai Barley Bridge. What it does? It just combines the two ends of the sea in the case of Mumbai. In all other cases, it is the river, two ends that you cannot cross since the flow of the water. It combines that end, those ends. The same is the role of this connecting you known as the salt ridge. Before that I go to the salt ridge, I just want to make you understand what is anode and what is cathode. Any part of the cell, please do remember, any part of the cell where the oxidation takes place, whether it is an electrolytic cell or it is a galvanic cell, right? Both the cases, this definition is absolutely correct and you can apply this definition. The anode and cathode, right? Two metallic rods are there which are dipped in their electrolytic solution, right? So, two parts are there. One is the anode and the other one is the cathode. Anode is the site of oxidation, the part where oxidation takes place. Anode, the charged magnetic rod. What is the difference between a normal metallic rod and the electrode? Electrodes are always charged. The charge may be positive or negative, but definitely and definitely they will be charged substances, right? And here anode is the site of oxidation. The oxidation, it takes place in the anode and its opposite cathode is the site of reduction. Two electrodes we are using in every cell. Every cell is consists of two electrodes. One is called anode, other is cathode. Anode is the site of oxidation. The cathode is the site of reduction. I am taking the example of this pure denier cell, right? And in this case, you have seen that zinc. At this phase, what you are seeing, the zinc, it was leaving its electron here, was moving inside the solution and the hydrogen 2 plus. Right? Here, the electrolation was taking place, the electrons were released. Hydrogen was converted into the Zn 2 plus by releasing the electron. So, this is anode, right? This one will be anode in the case of this linear cell. In the other part, what you have seen that copper 2 plus ion, right? It was taking the electrons from the rod and it was getting neutralized, and being neutralized, it was depositing around that particular copper rod, right? So there reduction was taking place, and the copper electrode where what was taking place, Cu2 plus was gaining the electron and was converting into the Cu. But right, the reduction was taking place, and that's why copper will be have as here cathode and zinc rod will be have as the anode. Right? What will be here? The zinc will be the anode and cathode will be the copper. Please never go for the charge. If you will account for the charge, in that case, whenever the nature of the cell will be changed, you may get confused. Always remember, anode site of oxidation, cathode site of the reduction. What is actually taking place? The zinc is converted into zinc ion and copper ions are converted into copper. Since it is neutral, it will get deposit, and definitely with the time you will observe a thickening in the copper rod. On the other hand, with the time this is going to be dissolved in the solution, right? And in that particular case, you will observe that this rod is going to be thin. With the time, this will become thin. So, if the cell will, by the redoxylation, what has happened here? A redoxylation has happened and it has given a and the flow of the electron is called electric current. From one to another, this electron is flowing, right, by the current. Now, what you can see here in the other part, for the rods, they are combined with a wire, and we have a voltmeter or an ammeter is combined, and that finds out the voltage or the current flowing through the circuit. If it shows deflection, that you can see no battery is here, right? In this circuit, battery is not connected. That means whatever the deflection you will observe in the voltmeter or ammeter, this will be because of the flow of electric current here through this solid mixture. Right? Now I am coming to the part solid bridge. What is solid bridge? Solid bridge, it is a hollow glass U-shaped tube. A U-shaped tube is generally used as the glass bridge. The cases where some cases, what is happening here, perforated holes bearing pots are used. In that case, there is no need of the solid bridge. But the cases where the half cells are separate, they are into the different containers, we need one connecting unit, right? We need one connector to connect these two half cells, and this is called solid bridge, right? My dear students, it is a hollow U-shaped glass tube. Generally, K2SO4, KCl, these solutions are filled with the agar-agar. A gelatinous substance is agar-agar, with that it is filled. Otherwise, a very high concentration solution is used, right? And this is the pathway for the molecule. It maintains the neutrality of the solution, right? So what are the two important functions of the salt bridge? Salt bridge is a connecting tube, a connecting device that connects the oxidation half cell and the reduction half cell. What is its role? It is a pathway, right? It is a medium through which the ions move from one to another, right? So this is a bridging one, and it maintains the neutrality. Otherwise, what you will observe? Every time if it is C plus is coming here, okay, if it is, if there is no movement, there is no connectivity, this will require charge. This solution will become electrically charged. To maintain this neutrality, right, this is the role of the solid bridge. Clear? So, what is a galvanic cell, or what is a voltaic cell, or what is a linear cell? A cell where the redox reaction takes place, right, it may take place in two different cells which are separate from each other. Otherwise, now in the advanced system, as the time has become advanced, the one pod is taken, and inside that one pod, a perforated another pod is placed with the magnetic rods, and the electrolytic solution is there. So in that case, there is a no separate holes will function. So basically, there are two parts of the any of the galvanic cell, oxidation half cell and the reduction half cell. The reaction taking place are called the oxidation half reaction and the reduction half reaction. Then a connecting device is used, and this connecting device is called the salt bridge. Very important, please note down what are the main functions of the salt bridge. The main function of the salt bridge are to complete the electrical circuit by allowing the ions to move, right? What is the important role of the salt bridge? It is a pathway, right? It is a pathway that completes the electrical circuit. Without this, the electrical circuit does not complete. The movement of ions, right, this is the function of the salt bridge. It completes the electrical circuit. The connection, the connectivity, the contact
of oxidation half cell and reduction half cell takes place by the salt bridge, right? This is one important function, and the another important function is to maintain the neutrality of the solution. Please make the note simultaneously as I am teaching here. The very important chapter. Now, I just want to take another lesson. Why? Because so that you never be adamant that all the time the copper will be cathode or zinc will be anode. It depends upon the set, it depends upon the combination that you are taking. Now, in this, the zinc is behaving as the anode and the copper is behaving as the cathode. Now, I am taking another example. We see it. Copper and AgNO, silver nitrate. You all know that silver is a very low reactive matter, right? It is the matter that is very low in its reactivity. What do you think? Copper will behave? How will it behave as? Now, if the copper and AgNO3 is zero, right? The reaction will be not that copper is going to be converted into the neutral. No, you can see here copper. I have already written as the neutral. When what you will observe in this reaction, the overall reaction you are taking it here as CuNO3 twice plus twice Hg plus. Now, we see here the copper at this place, its oxidation number is 0. Here, NO3 minus 1. So, what will be the oxidation state of copper here? Plus 2. That means copper is getting converted from Cu to Cu, 2 plus, and this is the oxidation reaction. That means in this case, this will be termed as the NO. Now, see the silver here. In this case, silver is plus 1. By the oxidation state, it's charged. You can say its oxidation number is 1, or you can say it is plus 1. Here, you see, this was for the previous, though not here, plus Ag. It's in the atomic form, that means it is zero. Any element in the form atom, always the oxidation state is zero. That means what the chain is taking place here, plus 1 to 0, and it's a decrement. And decrease or negative change or decrement always is the reduction. So definitely the silver, what the change is possessing, it is possessing Ag plus 2 Ag, and this is reduction and reaction. So definitely in this case, this will be termed as the cathode. Cathode, the site of reduction, and known as the site of oxidation. Clear? Now, the very important thing I am going to teach you all of you, my dear students, and this is representation of any electrical cell. How you present any dynamic cell, and very important, you must learn here, because in the questions, always this reaction is given, and from here, you have to predict, you have to do all the calculations. So you must know how we write. If you cannot, this much writing is not possible at all here. Right? You need a very long detailed information you will need. But you have to represent the cell. In that case, you need a shortcut method, a shorthand method. As we use the chemical reaction of chemical equation, it is a symbolic representation, it is a shorthand method. to present any chemical change. Similarly, to present any chemical electrochemical, the cell dynamic cell, we write the cell reaction. Right? Representations of cell reaction. How we write? What is subset of rules are there? And we will see not very difficult. By the convention, right? By the convention, always the left hand is the side for the oxidation, or you can say anode, and the right hand is the cathode or the reduction. Electric current, you all can see the electrons will move from here to here, but conventionally always the opposite is taken. By the convention, actually at the time the concept of electric current was given, the electron was not discovered. So that's why traditionally we were using positive to negative. It still is in the use. This is the direction of conventional current, right? That is always opposite, right? Always this is taken from the cathode to anode, since it is taken, it's conventional answer. This is not the direction of flow of the electron. You can see here the electron flow from always from anode to cathode. These are very important things here. In the chemical reaction, how we write? We always write the reactant to donor. Similarly, here also we write. We have to write the reaction that takes place in both the halves. Since it is written in the left hand side, always it is the left, always the anodic reaction or the oxidation will be written in the left hand side. You use the arrow to separate the reactant product. Here to represent the two different half cells, or to represent this salt which we differentiate, we separate it by the double line. Right? Always anode reaction, double vertical line, cathode reaction, and here the reactant and product of the anode and cathode, they are separated by a single vertical line. One vertical line is used to separate the reactant and product. What is the reactant here? Here it was zinc that has converted into the zinc 2 plus 9. So, Zn converted into the Zn 2 plus Rn. In the bracket, we write the concentration here. Suppose the concentration of this electrolytic solution is C1, right? What we will write here? C1, this is very, very important term. Whenever you will use the Nernst equation, a very important value you will find from here. That's why very simply, very slow paragraph progress. Now, this is the component reaction that takes place in the anode. Now, I am going to separate this with a double vertical line that will represent the salt bridge. That is the part that now I am going to write takes place in a different half cell of the reaction. Now, what is going to take place in the Cu2 plus? This was initially present as the reactant in C. Again, what you will write here to represent the concentration? Here you need a concentration term Cu2. What we will write? C2, since the ions are in the solution, so you will not write it here, but you will write here this place. This is the way to represent any cell reaction. How the cell reaction takes place? By seeing this reaction, you can come to the conclusion what would be taking place in the cell. Right? The one more example that I have taken earlier of the copper chain, copper and silver, I can write here in the form of the cell reaction. See how I am writing. Copper, it was converting into Cu. is senior, what is the subject plus? The very important things these are there in the terms of whenever you are writing the last equation, two very important terms to use. One is an, another is change in the concentration or the concentration. And that you will see, you will identify, you will find out whenever it is given in the question, just by seeing this. Now, how many poles are there? This is going to be the age. Now, of course, here again you need the terms of the concentration. Here, C1. Here, you will write the C. This is the way how you can represent any cell reaction. This is the presentation, always anode versus cathode, anode cathode separated by the vertical lines. In the case of anode, always neutral species is written first, then the ionic species. In the case of cathode, the condition is vice versa, right? Ion we write first and then we write the neutral species. This is the way how to represent the unit of the cell reaction. You can see here already I have written at the time I was showing the figure 4 all of you. Dear students, you can see how much effort we all are putting, and as we face some of the problem, we go for the alternative options for you. So dear students, please do the value of this hard work and please use it in the effective way. Please learn the things from the classes. My dear students, again I'm warning, I don't know actually when we will be face to face in our classroom with stable and this board. That's why take it as we are learning in our regular classroom. And all very slowly, and in the very class, I'm always taking the class in the real classroom situation so that you feel like you are in the school, you are in the class. Right? One thing, one concept I want to introduce here that I will discuss in the next part, and from there, definitely the numericals will start. Right? What do you feel if the ions are moving from here to here? Don't you feel overall, zinc sulfate is neutral, it's eta, if it is in the undissociated state. Zinc, it's the element, it's the atom, right? So it is completely neutral. But you know that here the chemical reaction takes place and this neutrality is vanished, right? And what difference of the charge is different? And this is the reason why the electrons flow. You all know if the level of charges are same, there is no possibility of flow of the electrons. Whenever there is a difference in the charge, then only the electrons will flow, and that will ultimately produce the electric current. And here there is a difference between the charges of this interface of the gene. The gene in this interface of the gene and this solution. At this surface, there is definitely and definitely a difference in the charge, and this is called electrode potential. The very new term, maybe you all are feeling, the electrode potential is the difference between the charge of interface of the electrode and the electrolytic solution. Similarly, here also you have seen the copper, it was moving, right? It was in the dust form, it was moving here. Again, here also there is a difference in the charge. And this difference in the charge is understood as the electrode potential in both the cases. Here, oxidation takes place, oxidation electrode potential. Here reduction takes place, reduction electrode potential. But nowadays, the international organization
the next coming class, I will take this part in the detail. Electrode potential, electromotive force, that is represented as the EMF, right? And we will discuss all these things in detail. That's why I'm just giving you the clue. Whenever no electric current is drawn from the circuit, the difference in the electrode potential is defined as the electromotive force. Whenever this is the electric current is taken from this, it is taken out from this, it is called a cell potential. For one particular electrode, for half cell, this is called electrode potential. In the case of anode, it is anodic or oxidation half cell potential. In the case of cathode, it is the reduction potential. The difference between, since there is a difference in the electrode potential of anode and the electrode potential of cathode, the electric current flows. The current flows only because there is difference in the electrode potential, and this difference in the electrode potential is defined as the cell potential. And whenever no electric current is drawn from the circuit, this is defined, this is known as the EMF voltage, is the unit for this. The cell potential always find it out by the E cathode minus E anode. In the next class, I will take it in the detail, and I hope you will come prepared and you will sit with the notebooks, and all your students simultaneously you go through solving all the questions related to this concept. At least 10 reactions you have to practice the word in the form of the cell reaction. You will practice at least 10 examples for the cell reaction. With this, this is the end of this session, and I hope the next session we will meet with the numerical part, the cell reaction, all these calculations, and you will be ready for practice test also. Thank you and have a nice time.